You're talking to Peter Quillen, Kid Chocolate. How you doing, sir? Pete?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
All right, man. All right. When was the last fight?
September 17th in New Hampshire. I fought in New Hampshire. It's my last fight.
How long ago was that? That was down there?
Almost a year ago. That was a little bit over
right?
a while ago.
Yeah, whatever. You hurt your hand, right? You hurt your hand?
Yeah, I hurt my hand in the fight, yes.
What's going on? How's your hand now?
You guys, you can see.
Get out of here.
I had like a rare fracture in my thumb, man. Really don't know. You know, I kind of punch hard or whatever. I don't know what the case may be. Had to analyze some things. And, now it's back to 100% now. I'm looking to get him back in the ring December 3rd.
Back up a little bit. So I get some luck. Who do you think you'll fight next?
I don't know who they need. They get a opponent for me just to go ahead and, you know, shake off the rust. But I'm really anxious to go ahead and try to get a shot at our titles.
You're a heavy hitter, man. Yeah. What's your record right now?
20-0, 15 knockouts.
15 knockouts. So it's going to be tough to get a... Guys going to be avoiding you like the plague, bro.
Yeah, they're supposed to, you know. Yeah. I would avoid me if I was me. But for the most part, you know, this is a tough and heavy game, man. You can't really take no...
Who do you want right now? Who do you
want
to fight?
I want anybody. Felix Stern. I want Sebastian Sylvester. I want Kelly Pavlik. I even fought Carl Williams. Like, if Kelly Pavlik got injuries or whatever the case may be, you know, he need to vacate his belt and let some real guy, hungry guys like me fight for the belt. I fight Paul Williams or anybody else for the belt, for that belt. I want to fight for the belt.
Who's the toughest fight you had right so far? 20-0.
I didn't know some Miranda. I fought Antoine Echols, but he wasn't as tough to me.
He wasn't as tough. Who'd you say, Miranda?
Didn't know some Miranda. I actually got the word that he's going to be fighting Roman Carlson.
Carlson, yeah. But Miranda, what style is this? Is he a southpaw?
Miranda, he was actually an orthodox fighter.
What made him so difficult?
He hit me. I got hurt.
Why was he landing shots on you?
It was a headbutt first, and followed by a headbutt, then a punch followed directly after the headbutt. You know, we clashed the heads, boom, and it was ruled a headbutt in the heavyweight in the seventh round. Kind of dazed me, then he followed punching, but he couldn't finish me. But through the whole time, I was like, had this process in my mind and said, what do I do next? So I actually was doing some thinking in the fight.
Made
me be composed still. Now I did not come up with the distance with him, actually. And I came back the next three rounds, 8th, 9th, and 10th, and swept those rounds.
Nice.
Put them in the bag. So out of 68 rounds, the goal, it's been scheduled for me to be, I've been scheduled, I think, 68, 69 rounds. Out of all those, I won 63, 64 rounds. So I only lost a few rounds through all them, those rounds I've been scheduled.
Man, the fights I've seen you fight, you have probably been a couple of your fights, I've only seen you fight about three rounds.
Yeah, usually they go. Either two rounds or less. Sam here was the only guy I went to, you know, the last round and stopped him in the last round. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
With accumulation of punches, showing people that this first six halves, the first six rounds doesn't matter. It's the last six halves, the second half of the fight that counts the most. So what I've been trying to work on my game plan is, like, you know, be as strong as I can in the first and be even stronger in the second half. Make sure these guys don't last at all.
What are you working on right now, mostly? What are you working on?
Not conditioning yet. Staying with the mentality. Just, I can knock anybody out with either hand, bro.
It's conditioning.
It's the conditioning and having the mentality of a fighter, being in the gym all the time. I took an old guy's advice when I'm from Grand Rapids. He said, take your mail to the gym and run every chance you get. So what do? I read my mail. I got a mailbox at the gym so I can receive mail there. I'm always there, man. You know, I'm trying to enhance and be the best fighter I can be.
All right, any word to, give me a word to the youngsters coming up.
I tell the people, for the most part, I don't expect every youngster out here to be a boxer or be a fighter, but for the most part, go out there and fight for what you believe in. Fight as hard as you can, because in this country, they are rewarded for hard workers. They are very, anybody that works hard in this country has huge rewards.
Awesome. Well spoken. Good luck to you, Pete.
Thank you, brother.
Later.